Hello and welcome to CCNA tutorial. In lecture 2, which was about basic VLAN configuration, we have learned that VLAN logically segment the switch into different subnets, and we have shown it by creating various VLANs on a switch. Those VLANs were unable to communicate with each other because they were in different broadcast domain. Our today's video is about Inter VLAN routing. In Inter VLAN routing, we configure a router that enables the various VLAN created on a switch to communicate with each other. There are various types of Inter VLAN routing. We will use a router on a stick, which is one of the type of Inter VLAN routing. In router on a stick method, we create a physical port on a switch as a trunk port that enables different VLAN to communicate with each other. We will follow these four steps in our configuration. First, we will create VLAN and assign port to it. So let's go and start our configuration. We will go to the global configuration mode of the switch. So let's go to the CLI of the switch and start our configuration. We will enter command enable config terminal. Now here we are in global configuration mode of the switch. For step 1, for creating VLAN, let me tell you that we will create two VLANs, VLAN 30 and VLAN 60. We will assign IP, this IP address, default subnet and gateway to VLAN 30, and this IP address, default subnet and gateway to VLAN 60. So for VLAN 30, we will enter VLAN 30, and let's suppose we are giving name HR. Similarly, we will enter exit. The same step will be repeated for VLAN 60. VLAN 60, and let's suppose I am giving name IT to it. IT, and will exit. Now, the second part of step 1 is assigning ports. So we can see here that port 1 of this PC1 is at port 1 and PC2 is at port 2. So let's suppose I am keeping PC1, I want to keep PC1 in VLAN 30 and PC2 in VLAN 60. So we will enter command interface port 1, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 30, and we'll exit it. Similarly, for PC2, we will enter interface fast Ethernet port 2, and we are keeping it in VLAN 60. So we will enter command switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 60, and we'll exit it. Since we are using router on a stick method, so we will create a physical port as a trunk port that will enable both VLAN 30 and VLAN 60 to communicate with each other. So here we will create a trunk port. Let's suppose I am creating port number 24 as a trunk port. Interface port number 24, switch port mode trunk, shut down, and we'll exit. Now 24 has been created, port number 24 has been created as a trunk port. So we have created the trunk, the step 2 also. Now I can show you that now VLAN 30 and VLAN 60 are in different broadcast domain and they are unable to communicate with each other. Here I can show you. Look here. If we send an echo request from PC1 to PC2, it fails. Look here, it fails. So to enable that VLAN 30 can communicate with VLAN 60, we will configure the router. Now we will go to the router and we'll follow the step 3, in which we will create sub interface and we'll do encapsulation. We'll use encapsulation.1q command to apply VLAN ID to sub interface. First, we will connect the trunk port to the router. The trunk port was port number 24. So we will create port number, we will connect port port number 24 of the switch to the router. Now, for creating sub interface, we will enter command enable config terminal. Now, for creating sub interface, we will enter command interface FA 0.1.1 is the sub interface of port 1 of the switch. Here we are in sub interface configuration mode. So now we will use encapsulation dot 1q command for and will assign the VLAN 30 ID to sub interface. Encapsulation dot 1q command is actually used to assign the VLAN ID to the sub interface. And now we will assign the IP address for VLAN 30. We are using 192.168.1.1 is gateway and the default subnet is. We'll enter no shutdown and we'll exit. The same step will be repeated for VLAN 60 interface fast ethernet port 0 port 2 sub interface is 0.02 and we'll use encapsulation dot 1q command dot 1q port 60. Now VLAN 60, we have assigned the VLAN ID. Now we will assign the IP address 192.168.100.1 and subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. We'll enter no shutdown and we'll exit. Now we have connected the trunk port 24 to the port 0 of the router, so we will up the port 0 of the router also, for which we will enter interface fast ethernet 0.0 and we'll enter no shutdown and we'll exit. Now we will exit and we'll use command show IP and brief. Now we can also show IP route. Here we can see that 192.168.1.0 is connected directly connected to fast ethernet sub interface 0.1 and this 192.168.100.0/24 is directly connected to fast ethernet 0/0.2. Now we can check our configuration that whether PC1 is able to communicate with PC2 by sending an echo request to PC2. So here we can see we will send echo request from PC1 to PC2. Oh, if else it take a bit of time and here it is successful. We can see that we can send an echo request from PC1 to PC2. This method is called router on a stick method, in which we have created a trunk port to enable the different VLANs to communicate with each other. We can also send a ping request to PC2 by entering we will enter ping 192.168.1.100.5. And we are receiving a reply from PC2. So this is all from today's video. For more videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.